Rahim. So inshallah today we will continue the story of Musa alayhi salam. So last class we did ayah number 136. So we are starting from this ayah today. Wa awrathna inshallah. Can we start with brother Rashid Khan please from Saudi?
وأورثت القوم القوم الذين كانوا يستضعفون مشارق الأرض ومغاربها التي باركنا فيها.
That's good.
وأنت أورثنا. What's the meaning of Aurasna?
You know the first derivative, like the first one or that we learned in level 2 was Varisa. You know what is Varisa. What does Varisa mean?
He inherited.
Varisa means he inherited.
Inherited.
So what do you think will be the first word of this word?
Varisa.
This is not from Varisa. This is the next derivative. This is third level word. Third level word, yes.
Aurasa. Aurasa.
Yeah, Aurasa. Like Aujada. Right? So Varisa, what was the Varisa mean? He inherited.
He inherited.
And Aurasa? He made someone inherit.
So this is a passive voice.
No, like this passive is not passive voice. He made somebody else inherit. Varisa means he himself inherited something. Okay. And Aurasa, he made someone inherit something. This is what Aurasa
means. He made someone inherit someone.
Yeah. So Aurasa, if we go continue with this, then it will be Aurasa. What will be the next word in TPI?
Aurasa, Aurasun.
Aurasa. Aurasa. Then
Aurasun.
Aurasa. Like Aujada. Aurasa, Aurasu, Aurasa. Then
Aurastum. Aurastum. Aurasna.
Aurasna. So what does Aurasna mean?
We made inherited.
Or we caused to inherit. You can say that too.
We cause inherited. The nation, Allazina, the one who, Kanu,
those who.
Allazina, those who, Kanu, they said.
No, this is not Kalu, it's Kanu.
Kanu, they were.
They were, yeah.
Yustad Afuna. What does it mean?
Yeah, this is, we haven't learned this chapter this time around. So it's like istaghfara yastaghfiru. Istad'afa yastad'ifu yastad'ifuna. But this is not yastad'ifuna. This is yustad'afuna. Istad'afa means he deemed someone or he considered someone weak.
They considered weak.
Or yustad'afuna is the passive voice.
Yeah.
So they are considered.
They are considered weak.
Yeah.
Mashariqa, the east.
So what's the? Is this a plural or singular word?
Mashar is plural. It's like plural.
What is the singular then?
Mashrik.
Mashrik. All right. So what does Mashrik mean?
The east.
What will be the first word for this one?
Sharaka.
Sharaka. Sharaka. Sharaka means?
Sharaka.
I didn't even get it. What you're making
I don't know. Sharaka means
he rose, like sun. Sun rise karta hai na. It's like he rose, like the. He rose means this is just the word means, used okay, for sun means, mostly. So what is Mashrik then?
Mashrik means the place from sunrises.
Right, exactly. So this is Ism Zarf, right? Mashrik. The place of rising of the sun. Yeah.
The place of rising is like Isma Makan.
Yeah, Isma Makan. Yeah, Isma Zarf for place and time.
Okay. Masharaq al Arda, the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Magharibha.
Wa, wa.
Wa and Magharibha. And the place where it sets.
What is Magharib?
The place where it. Goes down.
Yeah, so Maghrib, right?
As Maghrib,
similar Maghrib. To Mashrik, it will be Maghrib. And Maghrib will be what?
But it will be like plural of Maghrib.
Maghrib, the place of setting of the sun.
Place huh? of setting of the sun.
Yeah, we can say west.
The west, yes.
Yeah. Ha?
So the east and the west will be Maghrib.
Allah. What does Magharibah ha mean?
Ha is like feminine.
Mm-hmm.
So we can say that the place where it goes down.
Let's call Magharib the wests. Okay.
The west.
Make it easy. Magharibaha.
Wests.
Okay. Har wests.
Har wests.
Yeah, Magharibaha har wests.
Okay. Har wests. Yeah. Allati
Allati. You know Allazi or no?
You want to get up there, no?
Allazi. Allazi, the one who.
So what is Allati?
The one like is a feminine of the one who she.
Yeah, so it is the same meaning as Allazi, but Allazi is used for masculine for and Allati is used for feminine.
For the feminine.
Yeah.
Barakna fiha.
Barakna?
Fiha. Barakna means that baraka. In it.
Is it really baraka?
Barakna.
It is ba is longer, right?
Barakna.
So, what will be the chapter? We just recently learned it. You don't know. What will be the first word? Can you guess?
Barakna.
Barakna. So first word will be baraka.
Baraka. Baraka.
Baraka means
it's like a baraka.
Yeah, yeah. So baraka.
Barakna. So we all get baraka from it.
Baraka, he blessed someone else. Usne kisi aur mein barkat dali. Right? Baraka. Baraku, barakta. Okay, what will be the next?
Baraktum.
Baraktu, barakna.
Barakna.
We blessed.
We blessed fiha in it.
In her.
In her.
So now there are three words, brother. You see, this is her. This is again for something feminine gender. This is again her, right? So three feminine gender words are used. Why they are feminine and why what they are referring to.
So,
do you know?
No, actually, you can explain.
What is, brother Rida, can you tell us?
I'm assuming Ard. Ard is feminine, considered as a feminine.
Yes. So the earth is considered a feminine gender word, a muannath word in Arabic language. So any other word which will refer to it will be feminine gender. So that's why Ha is used. Its vest means the earth's vest. Allati is again referring to the earth. And Fiha also referring to the
earth.
Yeah. So let's combine it now.
Va and auras now.
We are just doing English now, no Arabic.
And we inherited.
We inherited
the nation, the one who was.
Was used to be considered as weak. Mm-hmm. Kana plus mudare. Past perfect continuous tense called madi istimrari, right? Kanu yustad'afuna. So
they used to be considered as weak.
Yes. They used to be considered weak.
East of the earth,
mm-hmm,
and its west.
Yes.
Lati.
The one
we blessed from it, or
in it. He means in, right?
He means in it.
Yeah. Jazakumullahu khair. I will just do one more time.
Actually, there's a comma.
Okay. All right. Jazakumullahu khair, brother.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. No problem. Go ahead. And we made inherit the east of the earth and its west, the nation, those who were considered or used to be considered weak, the one who we blessed in it. So Allah is talking about the Bani Israel, because Bani Israel were considered to be used to be considered weak, but Allah made them inherit what? The east of the land and its west, like meaning a vast piece of land, a big kingdom. And that kingdom was, that land was blessed. The Allah is saying we blessed in it. Allah had put barakah in that land. So you can imagine, like when we think of like the kingdom of Sulaiman alayhi salam, you know, it was a huge kingdom. So Allah is referring to something like that. So let's continue.
Let me ask you, brother, two questions.
Yes, sir.
Sharaqa, you mentioned, is it fataha or fataha?
Sharaqa ya shuruku. Shuruq or sharq. Similarly, gharaba ya ghurubu or guru, and ghurub is the master. Ghurub is also used in Urdu. We say suraj ghurub ho gaya.
Okay.
Yeah, and maghrib is the place of setting of the sun. This is ism zarf.
So it's going to be bab gharaba yaghrubu?
No. If I say gharaba yaghrubu, what it will be? What chapter?
Gharaba yaghrubu. Nasara yansuru.
Nasara yansuru, right? It cannot be fataha. Gharaba yaghrubu or sharaka yashruku will be bab nasara.
Okay.
Make sense?
Yeah. Second question is, you mentioned baraka. Is it bab taf'il?
Barakna is like what? Baraka is like what? Baraka is like jahada.
Okay.
Bab mufa'ala. Jahada yujahidu mujahada. Bab mufa'ala. Similarly, baraka.
Baraka. Yeah, yes.
Baraka yubariku mubaraka.
Mubaraka.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Brother Abdul Razak.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wattammat kalimatu rabb.
This is not kalimatu.
Kalimatu? Rabbika, Rabbika al-husna ala bani Israel bima sabaru.
Ji.
Wadammarna.
That's good.
Wattammat or mukammal kiya and completed.
What completed?
Who completed?
Tamma. What does tamma mean? Tamma. Can anybody tell what chapter it will be? Tamma. Anybody?
Janna.
Bab Mudaf.
Bab Mudaf. Very good. Very good. Tamma yatimmu. It's like dalla yadillu. Tamma, he was complete or he became complete. Okay. Tamma means what, Brother Abdul Razak?
He was complete.
Or he became complete.
He became complete.
So what does tammat mean then?
Tammat. We completed?
No. Fataha, he opened. What does fatahat mean? Anybody else?
He opened.
Tamma means he became complete. Tammat?
She became complete.
So just add a ta before after the word, then it will be feminine gender. She became complete.
And she became complete. Kalimatu, the word. Rabbika, the word of your Lord.
Your Lord, yeah.
Al-Husna, good?
No, this is not good.
Al-Husna.
Al-Husna.
The best.
Is it a feminine gender word or a masculine gender word?
Looks feminine.
It's a feminine. What is the masculine gender word for this? Equivalent to it?
Al-Ahsan.
Ahsan. So what does Ahsan mean?
It means the best.
Without al.
Best. Better. Like the one who is better.
Ahsan means better.
Better.
Al-Ahsan means the best.
The best.
Al-Husna also means the best, but it is used for
feminine
gender. Something is feminine here.
Just like the kalima is feminine, so Al-Husna is talking about kalima.
Yeah, very good. And similarly, tammat is feminine for the same reason. Yeah, okay. Keep going. Let's go. Al-Husna means the best. Okay.
The best. Allah upon Bani Israel, children of Israel, bima sabaru, with what sabaru, they showed patience. With what they showed
patience. They were patient. We can say that too, right? Sabara, sabaru, they were patient. Good. Let's combine this.
It was completed.
Like she became complete, right?
She became complete. And she became complete. The word of your Lord.
Brother, when he or she is the inside doer, what could happen? There could be an
outside doer.
Outside doer. How we recognize an outside doer? It comes after the verb and it has what status?
Marfu.
Do we see a marfu word here?
Is it Rabbika?
Kalimatu. This page is telling us that Kalimatu is the outside doer of Tammat. Okay?
Okay.
So we start from here. And
the word of your Lord, the best.
Now, the best, what is this? Kalimatu Rabbika. The word of your Lord, right?
Yes.
This is Mausuf, and Al Husna is the Sifa.
Sifa, okay.
Makes sense? So we will say the best word
of your Lord.
The best word of your Lord. Okay, makes sense?
Okay.
Because Kalimatu Rabbika is a ma'rifa, right? And Hal Husna is ma'rifa. And Kalimatu is gender, Husna is gender. It matches all its four properties. So we will say this is Sifa Mausuf. The best word of your Lord became
complete.
Very good.
Upon Bani Israel, upon children of Israel, with what they showed patience,
If we say with what they were patient, does it make sense? No, it doesn't make sense. Over here, B means because of. And let me say something now. Because of what they showed patience. No, we will say because of their patience. This ma is a special ma. This ma is called ma masdariya. And when this ma will act on this verb, it will change it into a masdar. A masdar mu'awwal, we call it. A made up masdar. Because of their patience. And the best words of your Lord, the best word of your Lord became complete upon the children of Israel because
of their patience.
Because of their patience. All right. Let's continue. Brother Ijaz.
Yes. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I'm going to try, Brother Shabazz. I don't know if I can do it.
You can start from here, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ودمرنا ما كان يصنع فرعون وقومه وما كانوا يعرشون and دمرنا I don't know
you may not know the meaning of this word but can you tell what chapter it is, and what is the inside door? Two questions only. Can you guess on the chapter?
Chapter.
Is it level 1, 2, or 3?
Level 2, I'm guessing.
No, it's not level 2. Brother Naeem, what is the level? Bab, what is the chapter?
Bab Tafsir, level 3. Dammara Allama yuallimu talim.
Very good, very good. So this is and what is the inside door of this? Dammarna.
We.
Very good. So even if you see a word, and you'd have no idea what it means, but based on what we have been taught so far, we should be able to figure out 2-3 things. Number one, what chapter it belongs to. And number two, what is the inside door. And number three, is it madi, mudare, amar, fa'il, maful, what it is? Even if we don't have any idea what it means, we should be able to figure out that, right? So this is what I think we should be good at, even before we know the meaning. So dammara means he completely destroyed, he annihilated. So dammara, he annihilated. So what does dammarna means?
We completely destroyed.
Ji, very good.
And we completely destroyed what kana, what was, yes, now, made,
He makes or he will make. Sana'a yasna'u. Like sanat. You know in Urdu we say sanat, yeah, sanatkari.
Yeah.
Things are made in a sanat, right? So
yeah.
Yeah.
So he makes or he will make Fir'aun wa qawmuhu and his nation wa and ma what kanu they were.
Very good.
Yarishun.
Yarishun.
Arish, like something.
You see, Arsh is a high, is something which is at a high spot, right?
Okay.
It's a raised spot. So we can derive from it. Arasha ya Arishu. Arasha means he raised.
So what they raised. What they raise or they will raise.
So ya Arishuna. They will raise. So can I ask you, Arasha ya Arishu? What chapter that will be? Very good, mashallah. Very good. So let's combine all of that.
And we completely destroyed what the nation of Fir'aun, what Fir'aun and his nation made.
Used to make.
Kana
plus mudare. So, same thing which happened here. Kanu yustadafuna. Same factor. Kana, yes, no. Past perfect continuous. Ji.
What they used to make and what they raised.
Again, the same thing you see is happening. Kana plus mudare. What they used to raise. And we annihilated, we completely destroyed what Fir'aun and his nation used to manufacture the schemes and plans and everything they used to make. And what they used to raise. They were very fond of raising tall buildings. So Allah said, we completely destroyed all of that. Jazakumullah khair, brother Ijaz. The time is up. We were able to do only one ayah today, but it was a longer ayah. Maybe it was a little bit difficult. I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, I have one question about Dammara.
Yes.
Can we say Dammara for like just destroy? He destroyed Dammara.
Yeah, we can say that. But there is a shadda.
I mean, completely destroyed.
Yeah. Okay. We destroyed. Okay, we can say destroyed.
No.
That's okay.
If Shadda is there, then we completely destroyed. If there is no Shadda, Dammara, destroyed.
Dammara, Dammarna. I have to look up, see if there is a first level word that exists and how it varies. I haven't looked up that. But Dammara, in its meaning, is complete destruction. Okay, that's why I was saying. And as a rule, not a rule, but generally, the Bab Taf'il words have some shadda in it, some intensity, like Qatala and Qattala. Remember?
Yeah.
Qatala means he killed. Qattala, he killed brutally. Right? Yeah. So there is an intensity, increased intensity. In words that belong to this chapter. Not all the time though. Not all the time. Okay? Yeah. So, I will just do one more time a full translation. Or maybe once somebody else should do this. Brother Ikram, you are still with us?
Yes.
Can you just do English for us and then we will do, where we conclude the class with that. Please.
Okay. I'll try. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. And we inherited the people, we made to inherit the people, those who have been considered weak, east of the earth and its west.
It's plural, brother.
east of the earth and its west. But we made the one which we made fruitful.
We put blessing.
We put blessing in it. And the word of your Lord and the good word of your Lord.
Not good.
The best.
Al-Husna
means, brother, we worked on this word a little bit. Al-Husna means the best.
Okay, the best.
Okay. Al-Husna is a sifa of another combination of words. What is that?
Al-Ahsan.
Sorry, I didn't get your question.
I am saying this is sifa.
Yeah.
What is mausuf?
For me, it's kalima.
Kalima?
Yeah.
No.
So is this?
Because kalima is nakira. This is ma'rifa. Do you see? This is common noun. This is proper noun. How it can be sifa mausuf?
Yeah, yeah. So it can be sifa of rabb.
You are saying but rabb is not a feminine.
Yeah.
So if rabb is not feminine, how it can sifa be feminine? You see the problem here?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how about we combine these three words? Kalimatu Rabbika, the word of your Lord, and treat it as one single phrase.
Okay.
And that whole phrase will be mausuf.
Okay.
The best word of your Lord.
Okay. And the best word of your Lord was fulfilled upon the children of
became complete.
Okay.
Yeah.
Upon the children of Israel, because of their patience, and we destroyed what Pharaoh and his people have been creating, and
had been raising, like the buildings and stuff like that.
Okay.
One more question, brother Ikram, for you. What is Bani?
Children.
It's
singular or plural?
It's plural.
What is singular?
Sorry?
What is the singular for it?
Ibn.
Ibn means son.
Yeah.
So what's the plural of Ibn? Brother Reza, you are saying something?
Abna.
Abna. And what's the other one?
Bani.
Bani.
Baneen and Banoon.
Yeah.
Banoon and Baneen.
Yeah.
So what is here? It is neither Banoon, neither Baneen. What is it then?
It is Bani. Yeah.
Baneen. What happened to the noon?
Noon is dropped.
Why?
Make a light.
Why we have to make it light?
Hudaf.
Okay.
Yeah, very good. Very good. So Bani Israel is what, brother Ikram?
Bani Israel is mudaf ilai. And
mudaf has to be?
Mudaf has to be light. Yeah.
Light. So Baneen was the original word, and to make it light, noon was
dropped.
So Bani, it is actually Baneen, right? Yeah. Jazakumullahu khair. So we are done for today's class. If there is any question, we can discuss. Otherwise, we will conclude.
You use a nihilated English word. How do you spell that word?
What word?
Nihilated.
Annihilated.
Annihilated.
So yeah, you are testing my English now, huh?
Okay.
Okay, I will try. Annihilated. A N N I H I L A T E D. I'm not really sure, brother.
It's I double N H I.
Yeah, I found it. A double N I H I L
L A T. Annihilate. A N N I H I L A T E D. Annihilated.
Yes. Jazakallah khair. I tried to find it. I couldn't.
All right. Anything else?
Can I have a question about the detail? Why using Masharik, like two east and like Masharik mean more than one, right? One east, two Maghrib.
This is an usloob, brother. This is an usloob. This is just to tell a way to describe a big piece of land, a vast land, very wide. Consisting of like a big area.
Okay.
This is, I know you're saying there's only one east, you know, but your east could be the west for someone.
Okay.
We can go into this discussion, but it will take some time.
Oh yeah. Okay.
So Masharikul Ardi wa Magharibilha, it just an uslub, a way in Arabic language to describe a vast piece of land. Very big piece of land. That's all.
Brother, you said the shalaga means raising, right? Raised. It raised.
He came up.
It came up.
Yeah.
And Qaraba?
Qaraba, he went down.
Went down?
He set. Yeah, it's mostly used for sun.
Okay. Jazakallah.
All right. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum assalam.